yeah. Oh yeah. Everything gonna be all right this morning. Oh yeah.
Thank you once again for joining us on Indiana All Access. And my name is William Alley. I'm an athletic performance coach at Indiana University. And today I'm joined by a number of individuals and much larger than our normal group on a Wednesday, which is awesome because there's going to be a lot of collaboration going on. We've got individuals from what I refer to as the Mecca at Springfield College. You go all the way out west, UW, and then we had to bring the Ivy League in here, all right, with Princeton, and obviously our very own staff at Indiana University. The conversation today will obviously go a number of different ways, but the biggest focus is our field and what we're doing and what a number of people in our profession are doing to make sure that we can continue to further the education of those young and up-and-coming coaches, as well as just create a vision for what the future can and will be for this industry. Myself, coming up in this industry, I've been basically the benefactor of some of these individuals that are pouring into young strength conditioning coaches, and it's only right that we give back. And so I hope you've brought out your notepads, I hope you fed your kids, and I hope you're ready, because there's a lot of information that I know is gonna be passed around, and things that we're doing, things that have been done, and things that are continuing to move this field forward. So without further ado, I'll hand it off to Tom and we'll get started with this week's guests.
That's great. Coach, I am having a couple of computer things happening right this second. Coach, would you mind jumping in for me here? William Alley.
Not a problem. So to start off this week, like I said, we have our guest from what I refer to as the strength and conditioning Mecca, Springfield College. We have Team Fight, as I was once introduced to them as, Mary-Kate Fight and Adam Fight from Springfield College. And I first met Adam actually here in Bloomington, which is funny because I haven't yet had the chance to go up to Springfield, but met at a summit here in town with guys like Joe Ken, Bobby Smith, Lee Taff, and just other greats in our profession. And it really opened my eyes as to what people are doing, and obviously the fact that he was working on a doctorate at the time and really studying some things to help improve our interns and help improve learning in our field. And so I've been interested since day one. I've been bought in. Everything that Mary-Kate and Adam have brought out into the world, I have literally tried to consume. And so hopefully you guys take as much as I have from them over the years and continue to really just further our progress as a field.
Awesome, Coach. Well, I appreciate it. It's always great to see you again. I'm very fortunate to have met you at that clinic in Bloomington, because it's really opened up an opportunity for our young coaches to continue their careers. So that's precisely what we're going to be talking about. So as Coach alluded to, my name is Adam Fite, and I serve on the senior staff of strength conditioning at Springfield College. I'm also a doctoral candidate in sport and exercise psychology. And we've got Mary-Kate here as well to talk about her experiences, not only as a coach, but also as a professor and a recent graduate in her research into developing interns. So I know our time is limited. I want to thank you, Coach Will, as the rest of IU staff for putting us together and having us on today. So what we're going to be talking about for the next few minutes is really how we approach our coaching development at Springfield College. Springfield College, yes, it may be considered the Mecca or cradle of coaching, but we're actually a very small private college in Western Massachusetts, only about 2,000 undergrad students, but a very pronounced and renowned graduate strength conditioning program that's very fortunate to be a part of and serving the roles that we're in. And how we approach our development is really based over, as most coaches and practitioners would call, a long-term development model. And what you're going to see here is really how our staff is set up. It's very unique because we have active practitioners in the field that also teach classes, And we have some what's called a funnel system of getting young coaches or students that are interested in strength conditioning to really set them up for a proper career path. So we have our head strength conditioning coach, also the graduate program director, Dr. Brian Thompson. He's taken over the program since Dr. Margaret Jones left in the early 2000s and has really grown it to the level that it is now. As such, we've got Mary Kate, who serves as the associate director of strength conditioning. And then myself, my official role is coordinator of physical and mental performance, where I serve in a supervision and mentoring capacity with our grad students, but more importantly, to bridge the gap between sports psychology and strength conditioning with our athletic teams. And from there, we're very fortunate that while Dr. Thompson, myself, and Mary Kate don't actively coach and write the programs and sets and reps for our teams, we're very fortunate to have a staff of 5 to 7 certified grad students in our program. And so they do a bulk of the legwork in terms of active coaching, where we go in and help supervise and mentor. Under that, we have our funnel system of graduate student interns, our first years, who complete about 100 hours. Then we also have a variety of undergrad interns that have to complete 450 hours and 90 hours for our junior undergrad students as well. So from this basic model, you can see we have a lot of opportunities that can set our coaches up for success, but most importantly, our athletes, because of the amount of integration we have in our academic and athletic department. Now, how it works is in our graduate program, and Mary Kate will be able to speak to this a little bit more, is our first year graduate students, we have a unique model where it's not your traditional, I'm signing up for grad school, I'm gonna take a 2-year position to complete my master's degree. Our first year grad students actually have to enroll in a 100-hour internship on campus. This allows us to observe their qualities, their skills and deficiencies before we send them out to great schools like IU and so forth. Within that, they also have to complete a 100-hour internship off campus, which is usually done during the next semester or the summer. And during this time, we're really focusing on the base courses at a grad level of strength conditioning and a class that Mary Kate teaches of strength conditioning applications. During that first summer, after they finish their first year helping us out, we then send them out for their big internship at Power 5 schools, could be private sector facilities, anywhere we're really going to match them up with a great mentoring opportunity. And then once they come back for their second year, they'll be in a position as a graduate assistant or a local coaching position. We've got over 600 student athletes at our college. So yes, while we have opportunities to work with our student athletes, we also have an abundance of opportunities in our community. And then from an academic standpoint, now they're working on their electives and a little bit more advanced strength conditioning. And then hopefully throughout this process, we're, you know, assuming it's around 2 years, they become great alums and eventually get that full-time coaching position. And so before I transition to Mary Kate, just a couple of the key principles that we're going to talk about is I think we all know tried and true that students are going to learn by coaching. This is an area of Mary Kate's research where we dive into not necessarily learning more about coaching will help you become a better coach. So as coaches and practitioners, we have to find the balance and blend of doing both. But ultimately, it comes down to if we want better coaches, again, it's a specific adaptation to imposed demands. We've got to be specific with that. Let's get them coaching. And just like we periodize our programs, we also have to periodize our responsibilities and delegations within our interns. So establishing some sort of progression model there, but also from a psychology standpoint, giving them opportunities of autonomy. Or essentially essential of control over their actions, over their thoughts, but also how their coaching journey is going to unfold. So very excited for Mary Kate to continue this discussion with you.
All right, so my research has been on internships and internship education. And you know, since I graduated in May, I've been on calls with over 15 colleges talking about this. So it's gonna be really hard for me to sum this up into another 5 minutes, but I'm gonna do the best I can. Number one, from talking to all these people, it seems that a big struggle is having our relationship with an academic program. So we're really lucky our academics is our athletics program, right? So I am 75% academics and 25% athletics, where Dr. Thompson is more like 50-50. So we are teaching the classes that our interns are coming from, right? So this creates a great opportunity for us to connect academic learning to the practical work experience. Now, for everybody else, I think it's really important to form a relationship with an academic program so that it becomes a funnel system for you. You know what they're coming in knowing, and they know what they're going to learn while they're with you, right? But the key here is you need to be kind of on the same page with what they're learning so that those connections are made. They're not seeing a lot of conflict between what they're learning in the classroom and what they're learning, you know, in their internships. So I really encourage all of you to find academic programs either at your school or at other schools. Come reach out to us. We definitely have certain programs that we send people to year after year after year, and those are the programs that have served our students the best. Another thing, a lot of people will ask me about curriculums, right? And I say, number one, make them useful, right? So, you know, I remember when Adam and I started RIPT and we started our internship program, we started with a needs analysis, right? And a lot of people think, you know, let's start at the big picture and work to helping them write a program. Well, and then our business partner said to us, yeah, that's great. They can write a program, but they don't know how to coach. And that was kind of a light bulb moment for us. And it took until I started really doing research that this makes total sense. They're learning, as Adam said, through coaching. Right? And if they don't know how to coach, that time that they're spent in the weight room is not as valuable, right? So focus your curriculum on making them coaches first. That's better for you because then they're useful for you, but it's also better for them because that makes it so they feel more confident being in there and they have more learning opportunities. Things to focus on here, coach-athlete relationships. A lot of students don't know the line between friend and coach, and rather they're not tending towards friend, they're staying so strictly as coach that they're not able to build rapport with their athletes. So don't tell them, go get to know the athletes. Tell them how. Tell them questions to ask. Tell them strategies, right? Help them build rapport by giving them specific actions to do. And then coaching behaviors. Where do they stand when they coach? From the front, from the side, from the back? When do they jump in and coach? Is it during a set? Is it after a set? And then we focus a lot on the role of the second coach, right? If you're up there leading a group, that second coach can be bouncing around, making a lot of corrections. They can be incredibly valuable, but they need to know what that role is. Otherwise, they're just going to stand and watch. And then providing frequent feedback, debriefing after sessions can be really powerful because that's when everything is fresh, right? What can you do better? And more importantly, what can we do better? So that way they feel part of the process. And then multiple formal evaluations. Don't wait to the end of the internship. Don't even wait toward the middle, right? Give them evaluations often, and in those, give them action steps for improvement. Don't say things like, go out there and coach. Well, what does that mean? You know, to us, we know what that means. To them, they don't know. Go out and coach. Isn't that what I'm doing? Right? So really give specific action steps for them to improve. Things to avoid here, throwing interns into the fire, right? When you throw them into the fire, if they do poorly, then they feel bad about themselves. They don't feel confident in their skills. And then they step back and they don't continue to perform, right? So give them progressive increases in difficulty. That way they have mini successes until they're able to take over a bigger responsibility. Don't give up on your interns. If they're not good at a task, I wouldn't say don't have them continue that task. Sure, have them continue it. But also look at what things they're good at, right? And if they're really good at setting up a bulletin board, add that to their list, right? Find something that they're very good at and have them continue to do that often while they work on those other skills. And then finally, don't assume that interns understand their role. I was observing my dissertation subjects, and a new team that used to train in the morning came in the afternoon, and they were so excited to work with this team based off interviews with them. And then they stood and just watched that team. And I was like, why are you watching? Get in there. And they're like, well, coach didn't ask us to. I don't want to step on his toes, right? So lack of initiative to me was actually them trying to respect boundaries, right? So make sure those interns know what you want out of them and reinforce those behaviors so that they know what to do, so they're stepping up to your expectations. And then finally, to finish it off, things that we're currently working on right now that hopefully I'll be able to present to all of you in the future, we're trying to create KPIs for our intern or for our students throughout the whole 2 years. So coming in from their undergrad to the master's, where should they be? To the end of the first year, to the end of the second year, and how do we measure those things? Another thing we're working on is an intern competency checklist. So there's certain tasks they need to be able to accomplish by the end of the internship, and creating a shared file so the whole staff sees when they complete certain tasks. And this is as simple as leading a warm-up to as complex as building rapport with athletes. An observation tool that can be used and validated to be a good tool for evaluating interns and evaluating coaches. And then finally, as many of you know, Adam and I are completing a virtual internship study this summer in which we are collecting information based off efficacy scores pre and post internship, as well as collecting data from a qualitative standpoint in order to look at what good things happen during a virtual internship and how can we integrate that into our internships in the future. And then what did we miss from not having our interns actually coaching. All right, that's all we have for you today. Adam, you want to jump in with anything?
I'm going to stop sharing. Hopefully that helps.
There you go.
No, that's it. I appreciate the opportunity. And, you know, as Will has said, like team fight, this is it's a unique situation for us because we're both coaches. We're both entering a phase of higher education. But we feel very strongly about improving the responsibilities, the roles of coaches, but also what we can do as practitioners for our next generation. And so please continue to stay in touch with us. I'm in the middle of my results section right now, so I apologize for the scruffiness. Hopefully I'll be graduating shortly, but please, at whenever the next conference is, wherever you are, whether it's live, Zoom, or in person, please reach out. We'd love to collaborate, continue to pay this forward. So thank you.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much, Team Fight. That was great. And the thing that I really envy with what you guys have going on there at Springfield is just the structure of your whole program. It's just incredible. And it's just something that me personally, thinking about my experience as an intern and undergraduate, is just really envious of. I wish I had something like that, you know. And I know we're working on stuff right now at Indiana that we're hopefully making it more similar to that and have that. So thank you guys so much for giving us that kind of blueprint to kind of follow in your guys' footsteps. So moving on now, guys, we're going coast to coast. We have Coach Nick over from University of Washington, and then Coach JD here from Princeton. So these guys have been really, really involved in the ongoing coaches circuit that's been going on for the online internship curriculum with a bunch of different schools involved. And guys, I'm just really excited to see and really dive into what you guys have going on and how this all has come about. So the floor is yours, guys.
Yeah, thank you for having us on, and shout out to the presenters before. We actually have two GAs from Springfield partaking in our program, and they've done a phenomenal job. So again, kudos for everything they've done there. And again, thank you for having us on here. Just kind of talk more about the coaches circuit. And I think, like many of us, you know, we got to a position with our internship and COVID hit, and we weren't really sure what's kind of next steps for us. And then all of a sudden there was this blast of Zoom meetings, and then there was a blast of virtual clinics. And it seemed like for the first month and a half, there was so much going on with Zoom. And, you know, I was meeting with some other coaches to talk about like softball specific work. And, you know, we asked as coordinators, you know, how can we take advantage of this? And some of the biggest takeaways that I saw through these Zoom clinics was there was different roundtables, you know, and there was like sports specific ones. You could really get to talk shop with them, and there's breakout sessions. And I said, you know, we can use Zoom to our platform. And then as I talked to the coordinators, it's like, okay, but if you have interns who have already done 4 or 6 weeks, how can we take advantage and learn from others? So I wanted to reach out, and it was kind of almost like a game of telephone where I spoke with Adam at UCLA. Then he talked to a friend, and sure enough, we had almost 12 schools jump on this call, JD and others on this as well. And it's turned out to be a really awesome program that I'm pretty thankful to be a part of. And we'll kind of go into some of the details of our structure and goals. But again, I'm just super thankful that other coaches have taken the position to step up. And whether it's presenting or being involved in our roundtable and other breakout sessions, like for me, it's just been a really great opportunity for all of our interns and GAs and everyone involved to connect with others around the coaches. And GD will kind of highlight some of like our major goals in terms of what we put together this summer. Go ahead, JD.
Oh yeah. And just to echo that again, thank you to the IU staff for having me on. And, this has been a really interesting opportunity. It's really awesome. Like, again, like it was basically a large game of telephone, you know, Coach Becky that, I'm filling in as a late addition for, because she just had her little bundle of joy, you know? So, she was the one who contacted me about this, because I was running around like probably many of us were doing, many intern coordinators are doing, trying to figure out what the heck are we going to do with our interns now that it's all virtual. And she reached out to me, and then I thought this was an absolute home run. You know, like I was still reeling under the fact that like we weren't able to meet and congregate at the CSCCA. And I talk all the time. What I learned from the most when I go to the CSCCA are not the talks, but the interactions that we have as coaches. So to have that opportunity and present that opportunity on a national level to interns from all different walks of life, all different areas of education, and all different schools was an opportunity that I couldn't pass up. And I thought that this is, if virtual is the way that we're going to continue to go, and we can't create that on floor model and on floor opportunity experience, this is going to be the next best thing. We're going to connect philosophically. So that's really where we're going. That's really where we're going. Like, our major goals to answer that question was, number one was, what are our interns going to get out of this, and answer that. And then number two, how are we going to benefit as departments, right? Like, now we have the opportunity to interact, and that we're really grateful for every coach brings a different perspective. So we have these different weeks ranked out, and now we get a perspective from that coach. And then when Coach Nick's about to talk about the weekly structure, we're able to see how that structure progresses out throughout the week. So we can go from formal to informal and allow our interns to get a better look on how the college strength and conditioning philosophy can blossom.
Yeah, so highlighting that, like, our Mondays are traditionally a lecture series, and each university represents, they have one presenter from their school, and it rotates each week. Again, that way interns, if they've been with your program, they don't want to hear me speak again on energy systems development. I want them to hear from someone else. Tuesday is kind of like your debrief day, and then you might meet with your coordinator or your respected school, highlight and review kind of what was presented on the Monday presentation, if there's any follow-up questions, or then you can kind of be specific, since we're not in person, about how those things are then applied to that university. And then Wednesday is our breakout sessions, which is my favorite day, because typically what happens for me is I go to conferences, I text my friends, and then I just hang out with them. You know, I don't really branch out. I just stay within my clique. And so on Wednesdays, what we do is we have three rotations, about 12 to 15 minutes of random assigned between GAs, volunteers, and coaches. And it's a great way for us to connect. And if you're interning with Princeton, well, now you get to talk to Washington, Indiana, UCLA, and it's a really good rotation. And I think it's really beneficial for them, because if they, you know, hit it off with Blaney, they can follow up with her and then, like, learn more about it. And that starts to build their networking and their branch. Thursdays, we've just added our, like, sports-specific roundtables, and that's open to anyone. And then it's really led by the interns and GAs. Like, if they have questions, this week we're going to talk about baseball and softball. They present them, and then we have a wide range from high school to professional, coaches just jumping on and giving their insights. Again, it allows them to kind of dictate the questions and the flow. And then Fridays is traditionally our guest speakers, and we'll try to bring presenters from different realms of strength, conditioning, or performance. So maybe it's private or a professional setting. And then we try to get kind of like legends, or maybe people who are specialists. So this week is Lee Taff, and I think we have Nick Winkleman and then Mike Atone. And for us, again, it's a really good way for us to learn, but also show young interns and coaches that college strength conditioning is the end all be all. There's so many different realms of fitness or strength conditioning that you have to find what fits your personality. And so when these other presenters speak about their experiences and pros and cons and, like, share that insight, I think, again, for them being young coaches, and for us as well, it just highlights other avenues that you can go. And I don't know, JD, I mean, for you, what's been some of the biggest takeaways that you've gotten so far from this summer?
You know, it's really, what's really great about being on the coordinator side about this is seeing and getting to interact with so many different people, you know, and a lot of staffs that, like, you know, we're all super busy, right, and during the year. And again, like, if we're not at these conferences, we have, and even at the conferences, we have, you know, 48 to 72 hours to be with each other. And we're trying to see everybody that we haven't seen in maybe over a year, you know, and with that, like, it gives us an opportunity to learn from so many different people, and to have the opportunity to interact with so many different people that have so many different viewpoints on a science that is so highly variable, that it's only going to come, you know, when this pandemic ends and we go back to whatever normalcy is, it's only going to come at the benefit of our interns, and then ultimately at the benefit of our student athletes. And for that, you know, it's a really great experience for me as a coordinator, because the other members that are on this call have really helped me sharpen my axe, you know, and get an idea on how to do things differently than the tunnel vision that sometimes we get as coaches. So it's really great for this. And now that we have a framework, you know, we can move into the future with some structure, knowing what we've just done, and now moving forward, bringing with the possibility of like bringing more staffs on, whatever we want to do. And for that, like, I can send it over to Nick again, and he can kind of talk more about that.
Yeah, I think, you know, everyone who's participating in this is coordinators. You know, the challenge will be if you do another virtual internship, or if you have an intern who just completed one in the summer, how do you keep it fresh for them? You know, there's gonna be new perspectives from the staffs, but are they going through the same curriculum over and over again? So, you know, things that we discussed was maybe we had a book club. Each department takes on one book with their interns. They take the notes or chapter notes as they go through the semester. And at the end, it's shared to everyone. Like, that's our big objective, is how can we continue to learn and reach out. And we record all our sessions and we share it amongst the staff so then we can use it for later use as well. So that's been really important for us. We talked about building in intern presentations as well and doing that within the departments and then share it again amongst everyone. Because then at the end of this semester, now you have like 30 intern presentations, you have 10 staff presentations. You're just kind of building this library. And again, as young coaches and coaches on the staff, it's great for us to kind of refer back to. And so I ask, if anyone is interested in joining or trying to, you know, team up for the virtual stuff, reach out to us. I think we're going to do some version again of this, or ask yourself, like, is this something that we can do with three other schools? It doesn't have to be this big organization, but maybe it's a good colleague of yours and you reach out to two others and just challenge yourself. Be like, hey, we want to learn from y'all's best and create a structure that works best for you. You know, ultimately during this time, we're just trying to use this to our advantage to be able to connect coaches and young staffs, prepare them for the next. And like our saying is, how can you use these 3 months to set up your next 3 years? And that's our really big takeaway for the coaches circuit. It's the connecting, it's the learning and growing aspect. And again, I just thank everyone who's been participating on these calls. It's been a blessing for me. I continue to learn each day. And again, super thankful that I can kind of share what our story is and hopefully get more people to participate this coming fall. So thank you, Kevin.
Awesome, guys. Now, the one thing, the one takeaway I have from just the coaches circuit in general is just, I think it's the perfect example of how to take something that could be really, you know, non-beneficial as a global pandemic and really being forward thinking and taking advantage of an opportunity and making an opportunity out of it. So I love the fact that of the breakout sessions, and you're right, Nick, it's going to conference. It's very much so you kind of just hang out with the same people you always do, and having those breakout sessions and just forcing people to network and get to know different people from all throughout the country is just really incredible as well. So I think that what you guys are doing and everyone involved with that coaches circuit is just, you guys are knocking it out of the park. So thank you guys for doing that. Moving on, now we have two people that are very, very important to me. Unlike a lot of other people in this field that bounce around to place to place, I've been at Indiana my entire career and started as an intern, GA, all that. And I've had the pleasure of working under Tom my entire time here and Lainey as an intern, and then now she's back. And they mean so much more to me than they even know. And they've helped me develop myself as a coach just by learning from both of them. So they're going to speak on what we're trying to do here at Indiana and how we're trying to mold our internship program into something different that I even went through into what it's going to be now.
Well, thank you, Kevin. That was very, very nice. You brought a tear to my eye. So let me paint the vision for you guys. It's the year 2024, and Indiana Strength has just graduated their first fully accredited, nationally recognized master's intern program. And now, I know it right now, I know before we even get to it, you're all thinking that one question: what the hell does that mean? So let us kind of define it. Let us tell you a little bit about what we're thinking. The graduates, they're made up of the most elite women and men from throughout the country. They've gone through one of the most extensive application processes that's ever been done. And they've had success in the most comprehensive athletic performance internship that has ever been offered. They've collaborated with some of the biggest coaches, teachers, and professionals throughout our field, but not only throughout our field, throughout the entire multifaceted fields of this profession that are out there. You see, for us, the idea, the vision has always been to build a program that's bigger than the walls of the weight room, It's to utilize every bit of resource that we have, and we have so many of them. And it's to build and use those resources to not only build great strength coaches, but to create great thinkers, doers. You know, our current model, we've landed some great, like Kevin said, I mean, we have these phenomenal strength coaches that have come through our system and become who we are. And they've also have great jobs throughout the country. But we just thought we could do a lot more. And so with the guidance and the leadership of Coach William Ali and Coach Laney Deppe, we dove in head first and tried to figure out what our blind spots are. What are we missing? And one of the most glaring things we found was we're not utilizing our staff at all. We are literally not worrying about the rest of our staffs from their perspectives to their knowledge to maybe the biggest thing that we are missing, the relationships that they all have. We were missing out on it because our model, the current model that we had, it pivoted off of that one lucky person. And I know JD has just spoken about that term, that intern coordinator. That person's in charge of not only the education, they're in charge of the coordination. They set the tone of the entire program. Most of our strength coaches, as Kevin alluded to, a lot of them have gone through our program. And the truth is, it's created great coaches. They're competent, they're autonomous. They know the rigors of what strength and conditioning is all about, and they know how to achieve. But for all intents and purposes, it was still that one person show. So for us to build a program that is in our vision of what 2024 is, we knew we had to put some pieces. We knew we had to pull different resources and we had to manipulate it a lot different. And this is what we did.
Our first step was academics. We have this massive institution that's across campus that has over 50,000 students come in every single year. And then on top of that, have an actual exercise science degree with hundreds of students that go through that. Man, we needed to tap into that. We needed to be in the front lines and be in front of the students every single day. So a way for us to do that was to be able to teach classes. And through teaching classes, we started to get more on campus, do more of the activities that were presented through the School of Public Health. And before you know it, we were at career fairs. And let me tell you about our first career fair that we went to. As we walked in with our RU stuff on, sat down, had our business cards, our little pamphlets that we made, and the bum rush of people coming up to us because they wanted to work with athletes. They wanted to work in athletics. They wanted to wear the gear, all that. We thought we had hit a gold mine. They said, oh my gosh, I want to start immediately. So we kept saying to them, okay, let's start tomorrow, 6 a.m. Let's see what you got. Yeah, let's go. They're ready to go. So we call up Coach Will. And we're like, well, we're going to have like 20 people tomorrow, like starting off. You better get ready. It's going to be crazy. Tomorrow morning rolls around, 6 a.m. Do you know how many of those people showed up? Just one. But that one was my guy, Muhammad, that I had one of my classes that I taught. So I was super proud of him. And he had his polo and khakis. And I was like, yeah, Muhammad, let's go. And he crushed his first day. But then, do you know how many days Muhammad lasted? That one. And that was it. So then we thought, okay, back to the drawing board. So now that we've been over to academics, how can we now formalize this? How can we make this a really good relationship that's actual on paper? So as most of you probably know, the NSCA and their certifications, they're going through a revamp with that and who can actually sit for their programs. And what they have is this thing called an education recognition program. So it has to be a certain university has to go through an accreditation process through them that basically says the students that go through them are ready to sit for their exams. So with several of us being on staff that are certified, we're like, oh my gosh, this is perfect. Here we are. We got to get this going. So we write up this proposal, take it over to the School of Public Health, and we say, hey, this is going to be awesome for you guys, for us. This is just a really a home run. So they sit there and look at it and they're like, yeah, this is really good. Who's going to pay for it though? And we're like, well, we will. And they're like, great. Sign it off. And we were off to the races and we were ready to go. So we are ERP accredited. So then, okay, what's the next step? Curriculum, big, massive project. So what we thought is, in order to build something big, you've got to make sure that you got to get all the voices involved. And think of the problem too. I know that you guys had mentioned it before with the coaches circuit is you have freshman interns, sophomore, junior, seniors, grad students, transfers, the random 30-year-old that comes in that wants to be a strength coach now, that have all these different levels of experience, but different levels of education, where they're at in their curriculum. We had to make sure that we had a really clear progression of wherever you're starting, we'll meet you where you're at, but you're always going to be able to end at whatever this is. And to be able to combine that with what we're teaching over at the School of Public Health and the curriculum for the exercise science degree program. So that was the next step. But I'll tell you the most important step was the last step, which is what Tom was alluding to, was our staff. We needed to make sure that we got our staff involved. And the amount of conversations that are held that our staff has with our interns early morning, late at night, after a lift, through text messages that are absolute gold, that's what makes us us. That's what makes our program and our coaches and sets us apart, that we absolutely had to bring it into our program. So we had to make sure that our coaches were not only being able to be involved in the writing of the curriculum, they are the curriculum. And so that big holistic part was really the kind of the tie-in that brought it all together. Now, I say this because we're not really bringing that much new content in. It's much more of a collaborative effort. And we're not really trying to reinvent the wheel. We're really just trying to grease it and pump up the tires a bit, and maybe shine the rims and give them some spinners.
So that puts us where we're at today. So currently, we're in the biggest overhaul of our entire intern program. But we're approaching it from a much different angle. We're approaching it from the team angle. We're using our team that surrounds us, and we're building a curriculum that not only builds great strength coaches, but it's teaching those foundational tools that crosses paths throughout all different professions. We're utilizing the resources of Indiana University and all the different people that are on this call through Coaches Circuit, through the relationships that have been ongoing for many, many years, but we're utilizing them in a different way. Now, we're here for one major reason, and that is, you know, we're investing in our overall professional development. But today, as so many of you have alluded to, we need to start really looking at, you know, how we're developing that next generation of strength coaches, how we're formulating them so that they're able to demonstrate what this profession is, what greatness this profession is, and who they are. And I'll end with this by saying, we need to figure out how to get our boy Muhammad to do at least 1 week of an internship. Thank you all.
Well, Tom, I think I'm just going to throw out my outro, because that was, I think, a perfect way to end it. So, yeah, thanks for stealing the stage there. But I want to thank all of our speakers today, the Fights, JD, Nick, Tom, and Lainey. You guys did such an amazing job presenting. But more importantly, you're giving back to this community and this field that has given us so much. And we're lucky enough, everybody on this call, regardless whether you're a strength coach or not, we're lucky enough to have these jobs and these positions where we have opportunities to work with young people, whether it be interns or athletes. And it's not the kind of job you should ever do less than 100%. And everybody that presented today, it's obvious that you're giving more than 100%. So, and I don't think there's ever been a more important time than now to be good at what we do. So thank you guys for joining us today. And more importantly, I want to thank everybody for joining us today. You guys are the reason why we can keep going and keep presenting, because you're hungry to get better. And so we're just going to keep putting it out there. We'll be back next week. We're waiting for our last speaker to confirm. And once we have all of our speakers to confirm, we'll release that. So make sure you keep your eye on IndianaStrength.com and our Instagram page today or tomorrow. We'll release our lineup for next week. But with that, thank you again, and stay safe out there. So a little round of applause for everybody. Thanks, guys.